Okay, good morning, students.
Morning, ma'am.
How are you today?
I am fine.
Yeah, I'm great today. Okay, good morning for all our students, especially the students of grade 10, SMTK and SMAP, the students of Sekolah Cahaya Negeri Sidikalang, and all the students, especially around Dairi Regency, and for whoever who are watching this program now. And we come back for this program, STN Mengajar. And we do hope this program will be useful for you and for all the listeners of GET 88.2 GET FM, Wisdom and Life for you. But before starting our topic today, students, let's pray first. Okay, I invite Tabitha to lead the prayer. Yes.
Let us pray. The Almighty God, thank you for your great grace for us till now. We will start our lesson. Please give us wisdom to please give us wisdom to understand the lesson well. Please bless our teacher, who teach us wisely and patiently. Thank you, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Okay, students and for the listeners, before starting our new topic for today. It's better if we start our activities today by reading the Bible first. Okay, I take the Bible first for this morning from Jeremiah 29, verse 11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Yeremia 29 ayat yang ke-11. Sebab aku ini mengetahui rancangan-rancangan apa yang ada padaku tentangmu, yaitu bukan rancangan kecelakaan tetapi rancangan damai sejahtera yang memberikan harapan kepadamu. Oke, demikianlah firman Tuhan yang bisa saya bagikan pada pagi hari ini secara khusus untuk anak didik kami, yaitu siswa-siswi kelas 10, baik itu on fighting. We have to help the government. Topic today is about recount text, but before starting our singing, yeah, yes. I think we have known this song. Let's sing together. Yeah, the first verse. Can you start? No. Okay. When you look at others with their lands and gold, think that Christ has promised you his wealth untold. On your many blessings wealth can never buy. Your reward in heaven or your home on high. Count your blessing, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God hath done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God has done. Okay, this song reminds us about although we face a lot of problems, especially nowadays, but God also reminds us to remember for all his great bless for us, ya. Meskipun dengan situasi yang saat ini kita banyak merasakan suka ataupun duka, terlebih berhubungan dengan COVID-19, Tetapi lagu ini mengingatkan kita supaya kita selalu berserah kepada Tuhan. Ya, jangan menghitung yang enaknya saja. Jangan hanya menghitung sukanya. Tetapi ketika ada duka juga, kita diingatkan supaya kita mengingat Tuhan. Ya, okay. Students, before starting our topic today, namely lyric context, I want to ask you, do you have any experiences? Adakah pengalaman-pengalaman yang pernah kalian rasakan? Misalkan pergi berliburan, pernahkah itu? Ya, pasti pernah ya. Bagaimana dengan bunga? Ya, pernah ya. Okay, our topic today is about recount. Recount text. Ya, apakah itu recount text? Ya. What is the definition of recount text? Yeah, we come to the definition. What is recount text? Recount text is a text which retells the activity, the events, and experiences in the past. Okay, anak-anak, ya. Pengertian dari recount text itu adalah sebuah teks yang menceritakan kembali pengalaman, peristiwa, kemudian kegiatan-kegiatan yang kita lakukan di masa yang lampau, yang sudah lewat ya. So that is the definition of recount ya. Okay. Now the second is the purpose. Ya, purpose itu just the same with goals, ya. Apa tujuan dari dibuatnya text recount ini? Apa tujuannya? Ya, pasti ada tujuannya. Tujuannya yaitu to give the information or to entertain the readers or listeners. Yeah, students, the purpose of the recount text is to give the information or to entertain the readers or the listeners. Yeah, tujuan dari dibuatnya text recount ini adalah untuk menyampaikan informasi ataupun memberikan hiburan kepada pembaca ataupun kepada orang yang mendengarkannya. Itulah tujuan dari dibuatnya text recount ini. Ya. Nah, kemudian setelah dari purpose ini, yang ketiga adalah generic structure. Ya, apakah yang dimaksud dengan generic structure? Yang dimaksud dengan generic structure di sini adalah struktur teksnya. Ya, jadi penulisan recount itu pasti ada strukturnya ya. Yang pertama di situ adalah orientation. Ya, bagian yang pertama itu dari teks recount adalah orientation. Ya. Apakah itu yang dimaksud dengan orientation? Ya, orientation yang di sini adalah the information as the background of the events. To make the readers understand about the text. Who involved, where, and when it happened. Yeah, so students, the orientation as the generic structure of the generic structure of recount, yaitu the information as the background of the events to make the readers understand about the text, who involved, where, and when it happened. Yaitu untuk mengetahui apanya, ya, untuk memperkenalkan partisipannya, tokohnya di dalam teks itu siapa yang diceritakan. Who involved, siapa yang terlibat, siapa partisipannya, siapa tokohnya, kemudian where, di mana. Nah, jadi kegiatan itu atau peristiwa itu pasti ada tempat terjadinya di mana, ya. Oke, kemudian when, kapan terjadinya, ya, itu dia. Itu adalah orientation. Oke, kemudian bagian kedua dari generic structure itu adalah events. Events. Ya, events-nya itu adalah in chronological order. Ya, events-nya itu adalah serangkaian peristiwa yang terjadi di masa lampau. Nah, kemudian itu disusun berdasarkan kronologisnya. Ya, jadi kalau misalkan mulai dari pagi, kamu mau menceritakan pengalamanmu mulai pagi sampai malam misalkan, ya. Nah, kamu mulai di situ, pasti peristiwa mulai dari pagi, siang, sore, sampai malam. Jadi, tidak dibuat dulu peristiwa di malam hari, baru masuk ke siang hari. Ya, oke, itulah events-nya. Kemudian bagian yang ketiga dari hal ini adalah reorientation. Reorientation, yaitu personal command. Personal command of the writer, of the writer, or the end of the text. Ya, reorientation ini adalah bagian yang menceritakan atau memberitahukan komentar, rangkuman, ataupun kesimpulan dari penulis tentang teks recount itu sendiri. Ya, jadi paragraf ini bisa menjadi akhir, the end of the text, ya, menjadi akhir dari teks recount itu sendiri. Oke, itu adalah generic structure dari teks recount. Kemudian kita masuk ke bagian yang keempat, yaitu language features. Ya, apakah yang dimaksud dengan language features? Kaidah kebahasaan dari teks itu, ya, kaidah kebahasaan dari teks recount. Nah, yang pertama itu adalah the using of past tense. The using of past tense. Oke. Namanya juga ceritanya sudah di masa yang lampau. Pastinya tenses yang digunakan di dalam teks recount itu adalah past tense, ya. Nah, example-nya itu ya bisa dia I went to Medan yesterday, ya. Jadi mana dia menunjukkan past tense? Ini dia, ya. Okay. My mother was happy last night. Ya. My mother was happy last night. Yang mana dia menunjukkan bahwa kalimat itu ditulis dalam bentuk past. Was last night. Okay? Nah, setelah penggunaan dari past tense, yang kedua itu adalah penggunaan past continuous tense. Oke, contohnya apa saja? I was reading a book when the bell rang. Ya, was reading, ya. Itu dia past continuous-nya. Nah, kemudian di sini pasti past. Kemudian, they were listening to the music when father arrived. Yeah, we're listening to the music when father arrived. Okay? Ya, itu adalah ciri kebahasaan yang pertama dari rekam teks. Penggunaan past tense, kemudian past continuous tense. Okay? May we continue? Students, may we continue?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Nah, kemudian penggunaan apa? Rekam teks itu fokus on the participants. Ya, rekam teks itu fokus kepada siapanya? Kepada tokohnya. If the rekam teks, if personal rekam, contohnya di situ ada I, the writer, penulisnya. Ya kan? Nah, jika dia historical rekam, itu ada for example, Insinyur Soekarno, Bung Tomo, and so on. Ya, itu adalah contoh-contoh nanti ada di historical recount. Kemudian, penggunaan the using of action verb. Action verbs. Di situ ada kata state. State, walked, went, and so on. Ya, dan lain sebagainya. Ya. Kemudian, setelah dia, the using of action verbs itu, kaidah kebahasaan selanjutnya dari rekam teks itu adalah the using of conjunction. Conjunction. Ya. Penggunaan kata penghubung. Ya, karena dia diceritakan secara kronologis. Nah, pasti ada kata kemudian, yang pertama, selanjutnya, setelah itu, sebelumnya, dan lain sebagainya. Ya. Situ ada kata then, before, after, and so on. Kemudian yang terakhir adalah the language features of recount text is the use of passive voice. The use of passive voice. Nah, passive voice itu apa, Mem? Ya, kalimat yang diucapkan dalam bentuk pasif, ya. Jadi kalau kalimat aktifnya saya membaca buku, kalimat aktifnya buku itu dibaca oleh saya, ya. Bunga memakan sepiring nasi. Pasifnya, sepiring nasi dimakan oleh bunga. Ya, jadi ada kalimat aktifnya, ada kalimat pasifnya. Kata kerjanya itu, ya, dalam bentuk aktif maupun pasif. Nah, dalam hal ini, language features yang terakhir dari sebuah recount text itu adalah penggunaan passive voice. Contohnya, the bottle was filled with the ink. Ya, botol itu dipenuhi oleh tinta. Okay? Can you see? Can you read? Okay. I'll review before maybe you need to write it. Right? Okay? Recount text. Yeah, the first that we have to understand is the definition of the recount text. The definition, recount text is a text which retells the activities, the events, and the experiences in the past. Okay? Jadi menjelaskan peristiwa-peristiwa ataupun kejadian-kejadian yang terjadi di masa yang lampau. Okay, the purpose of recount text. To give the information or to entertain the readers or listeners. Ya, menyampaikan informasi ataupun menghibur pembaca ataupun pendengarnya. Oke, yang ketiga adalah generic structure yang terdiri dari tiga bagian, yaitu bagian yang pertama, orientation, the information as the background of the events to make the readers understand about the text, who involved, where, and when it happened, and the events, a series of events in chronological order. Ya, rangkaian peristiwa yang dihadirkan di dalam teks itu secara kronologis. Kemudian yang terakhir dari generic structure itu adalah reorientation, yaitu personal comment of the writer or the end of the text. Ya, apa yang terjadi? Ya, apa yang terjadi pada akhirnya? Nah, jadi reorientation itu masuk kepada kesimpulan, rangkuman atau dari penulis teks tersebut. Okay, the language features-nya yang pertama yaitu the using of past tense, and then the using of past continuous tense, and then focus on the participants, and the using of action verbs, the using of conjunction, the use of passive voice. Okay, you need to write it. Okay, students, we come back for this lesson. Yeah, after finishing write it, now I invite Bunga and Tabitha to come to the front to stick the paper I had divided to you. Okay, but you have to pay attention to the definition, the purpose, the generic structure, and the language features. Okay, by and by I'll give you the reward. Yeah, okay, we started. Are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, can me your pen, please. Bunga, can you help me to stick the paper?
Okay, the definition of the context. The language features.
Okay.
Not too much glue.
Okay, thank you. Okay, you compete with Tabitha to stick it. Nah, kalian tempelkan di mananya yang cocok ya. Jadi nanti mem kasih rewardnya siapa yang betul semuanya. Okay, Bunga and Tabitha, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, we start from now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, hurry up. Siapa yang lebih cepat? Okay. Yeah, not too much glue. Jangan terlalu banyak lemnya, deh. Ya, hari ya. 5, 4, 3, 2. Mona, I think you can help them to make the glue. Okay, hari up. Okay. Next. 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay. Okay, can you finish? Okay, I think I consider that this is Tabitha's answer. Tabitha and Bunga, right? Okay, never mind. Yeah, Bunga and Tabitha. Hayya, 5, 4, 3. 2. Okay, 1. Okay, it's enough. Okay, sit down, please. Thank you, Bunga and Tabitha. Okay, let's check it. Okay, the definition first. Okay, the definition. Recon text is a text, a recon text. Okay, good. Okay, super. And the purpose, okay, excellent. And then generic structure, reader's background, status of events using known, personal, okay, yes, Yes? Okay. Okay, whose paper is this? Is this yours, Bunga? Okay, never mind. Okay, two thumbs for you. Okay, the both of you. Okay, please show the text. Now, yeah, the text, Mona, the text. Yeah, the Battle of Surabaya. Okay, students, after finishing to study about recount text, okay, we will analyze one example of recount text. Yeah, the recount text consists of several types such as diaries, journals, autobiographies, and biography, and anything else related to histories. And it is called historical recount. Jadi contoh-contoh dari recounts itu masuk kepada surat, jurnal, biografi, autobiografi, dan juga semua hal ataupun cerita-cerita yang berhubungan dengan sejarah. Yang dalam hal ini disebut dengan historical recount. Okay? In this occasion, we will analyze about the example of a historical recount, which titled The Battle of Surabaya. Ya, jadi contoh teks yang akan kita bahas kali ini adalah dari teks recount tentang sejarah yang berjudul Pertempuran di Surabaya. Okay, I think Bunga and Tabitha may pay attention to the paper I had given to you. Okay, Bunga, I'll give you time to read the first paragraph on 10 November, okay?
On 10 November, Indonesia celebrates Hari Pahlawan or Heroes Day in remembrance of the Battle of Surabaya, which started on that very day in the year 1000. The bloody battle took place because Indonesia refused to surrender the reforming British army. British army at the time was part of the Allied forces. The Defense Bung is the will new revolutionary leader who played a very important role in this battle.
Okay, thank you, Bunga. The second paragraph, Tabitha.
It all started because of a misunderstanding between British troops in Jakarta and those in Surabaya. Under the command of Brigadier A.W.W.S. Malevi, Brigadier Malevi already had an agreement with Governor of East Java, Mr. Surya. The agreement stated that British would not ask Indonesian troops and militia to surrender their weapons.
Okay, thank you. I'll help you to read it. You may find out the new vocabularies, you may write the pronunciation, okay? Can you see the text? Can you see the text, Bunga and Tabitha? Okay. On 10 November, Indonesia celebrates Hari Pahlawan or Heroes Day in remembrance of the Battle of Surabaya, which started on that very date in the year 1945. The bloody battle took place because Indonesians refused to surrender their weaponry to British Army. British Army at the time was part of the Allied forces. The Divine Bung Tomo is the well-known revolutionary leader who played a very important role in this battle. Yeah, let's pay attention to the first paragraph, okay? The generic structure of recount text, orientation. So the first paragraph, here, is the orientation. Okay? Who involved? Siapa yang terlibat di dalamnya? Yaitu siapa? Siapa yang terlibat? Iya, British Army. British Army. And then Bung Tomo and so on. Okay? Where? The events, where?
Surabaya.
Yes. In Surabaya. So this is the participants. Where? It means the place in
Surabaya.
In Surabaya. Okay. And then when?
On 10 November.
When? Yes. 10 November. To answer the time, okay? When? 10 November. Nineteen forty-five. Okay? Now we come to the second paragraph. It all started because of a misunderstanding between British troops in Jakarta and those in Surabaya under the command of Brigadier A.W.W.S. Mallaby. Brigadier Mallaby already had an agreement with Governor of East Java, Mr. Surya. The agreement stated that British would not ask Indonesian troops and militia to surrender their weapons. Up to, okay, this paragraph. However, a British plane from Jakarta dropped leaflets all over Surabaya. The leaflets told Indonesians to do otherwise on 27 October 1945. This action angered the Indonesian troops and militia leaders because they felt betrayed. On 30 October 1945, Brigadier Mallaby was killed as he was approaching the British troops post near Jembatan Merah or Red Bridge, Surabaya. There were many reports about the death, but it was widely believed that the brigadier was murdered by Indonesian militia. Looking at this situation, Lieutenant General Sir Philip Christensen brought in reinforcements to seize the city. In the early mornings of 10 November 1945, British troops began to advance into Surabaya with cover from both naval and air bombardment. Although the Indonesians defended the city heroically, the city was conquered within 3 days and the whole battle lasted for 3 weeks. In total, between 6,000 and 16,000 Indonesians died, while casualties on the British side were about 600 to 2,000. Okay? From this paragraph after this. The second part of general structure is about the events. Peristiwa apa saja yang terjadi di dalam teks itu. Jadi mulai dari paragraf yang kedua sampai 2, 3, 4, 5. Yang kedua sampai dengan, ya, the second paragraph. Itu menceritakan apanya? Eventsnya, peristiwanya yang terjadi dalam teks itu. Peristiwa yang pertama di situ apa? Misunderstanding between British troops, ya, in Jakarta and those in Surabaya under the command of Brigadier A.W.W.S. Mallaby, ya, misunderstanding. The agreement stated that British would not ask Indonesian troops and militia to surrender. Ya, British Army will not ask Indonesian troops and militia to surrender their weapons. Ada British Army, ya, would not ask Indonesian. Ya, tentara Inggris tidak akan meminta pasukan Indonesia untuk menyerah. Itu adalah peristiwa yang pertama. Peristiwa yang kedua itu di paragraf selanjutnya. Ya. However, a British plane from Jakarta dropped the leaflets all over Surabaya. The leaflet to Indonesian to do arise. Ya, this action angered the Indonesian troops. Ya. Kemudian, dari pesawat Inggris itu menjatuhkan di seluruh Surabaya. Apa yang dijatuhkan di situ?
leaflet, ya, yaitu slogan-slogan untuk mengatakan bahwa hari terakhir bagi bangsa Indonesia untuk menyerah itu adalah tanggal 27 Oktober 1945. Nah, dalam hal ini, itu adalah peristiwa yang kedua, ya, the second event, okay, of the context, itulah yang membuat bangsa Indonesia di Indonesian terms angered, ya, merasa marah karena merasa dihianati, ya. The Indonesian troops and militia leaders, they felt betrayed. Nah, they felt betrayed itu tadi masuk kepada language features-nya, yaitu penggunaan passive voice, ya. The Indonesian troops and leaders felt betrayed, merasa dikhianati. Masuklah ini kepada language features-nya tadi, yaitu passive voice. Okay? Nah, kemudian peristiwa yang ketiga. Ya. Event, the third event, what is it? Brigadier Melaby was killed, ya. Brigadier Melaby was killed. Terbunuh. Ya, Brigadir Melaby itu terbunuh saat itu. Ya, di dalam pertempuran itu. Kemudian, ya, terbunuh di Jembatan Merah. Itu adalah peristiwa yang ketiga. Okay, the next event. Peristiwa yang keempat itu adalah the fourth event is in the early morning, British troops began to advance into Surabaya with cover, but with naval and air bombardment, the Indonesian defend the city heroically. The city was conquered in 3 days. Ya, pada akhirnya dalam 3 hari pasukan Indonesia bisa melumpuhkan pasukan penjajah dalam 3 hari. Itulah peristiwa yang selanjutnya, within 3 days. The whole battle lasted for 3 weeks in total. Yes, Indonesian died on this where about. Okay. Dari pihak Indonesia, ya, peperangan itu berlangsung selama 3 hari, ya. Itu adalah peristiwa yang keempat. Dari pihak Indonesia, 6.000 sampai 16.000 meninggal. Itu adalah peristiwa. That is the event. Okay. Nah, dari pihak Inggris, yang meninggal adalah sekitar 600 sampai 2.000 orang. So that is the last event from the context. Jadi itu adalah beberapa peristiwa yang terdapat di dalam teks recount ini, yaitu historical recount, yaitu the series of events-nya ada misunderstanding British Army between Indonesian troops and leaders. Yang kedua adalah Indonesian troops and leaders felt betrayed, ya. Kemudian peristiwa yang ketiga adalah Brigadier Melaby was killed, terbunuh di Jembatan Merah. Kemudian yang keempat, peperangan itu berlangsung selama 3 hari, dan dari pihak Indonesia yang meninggal sampai dengan 16.000 orang, dari pihak Inggris sampai 2.000 orang. Itu adalah peristiwa yang selanjutnya. Jadi rangkaian peristiwa itu di dalam rekonteks itu masuk kepada generic structure, yaitu a series of events. Okay? Now the last one, the reorientation. The reorientation. Battle of Surabaya caused Indonesian to lose weaponry, which hampered the country's independence struggle. However, the battle provoked Indonesian and international mass to rally for the country's independence, which made this battle especially important for Indonesian national revolution. Okay, jadi paragraf yang terakhir itu masuk kepada reorientation. The personal comment of the writer. What happened at the end? So that is the end of the text. Okay, jadi paragraf yang terakhir ini masuk kepada reorientation. Reorientation. And this is series of events. Okay. Okay, students, any questions so far? Ada pertanyaan? Bunga and Tabitha? Okay, have you understood? Okay, so I think for the next time, if I give you the task to analyze the other text of recount, I think you will be able, right? Okay, I think that's all for today, students. As for the students and for the listeners who stay at home, who work from home, keep healthy, keep on fighting the COVID-19, keep on praying to God so that God always bless us wherever we are. And see you next time. Bye-bye. Okay, Bunga. To close our meeting for today, I invite Bunga to lead the prayer.
Let's pray. Thank you, Jesus, for the day and help that today and have given us today. We went to go home. Please take care of us. Thank you, God. Amen.
Amen. Okay. See you next time, students.